Things In this video, I'll show you how to set up and manage live streams.
What is that? Oops, sorry about that. I need my glasses, y'all. There we go.
Around your life, everybody.
Aren't you guys? We got like just a couple of minutes. Just so you know what I've got here, I've got a couple sets of weights. The other thing I want you to have today is like a little hand towel. You know, something that's, I don't know, about that big. And we're going to wind up rolling it into a little tube like that and use that a little bit with some leg exercises. And we'll also use it for stretching. Hang on just a second. I got to adjust my sound. I'm too loud. I think I'm blowing out the speakers. There we go. How's that? Now a little loud still. That looks better. Gotta make sure I'm not blowing you guys out. So we got about 3 minutes. Good morning. Pause that for a second. All right. I just realized I forgot to send out a reminder to you guys this week. Oh, I'm still trying to figure out this whole live streaming thing. Let me take this up just a bit. Hopefully you guys can see me. Guess what I did? I put my shirt on inside out. Hang on a second. Try that again. There we go. That looks a lot better. Okay. Good morning. We are doing strength and balance. What you need today is one or two sets of weights or something you can use that is weighted, some lighter ones and some heavy ones. Or if you just got one set of weights, that is fine. I'll put these down here. We are going to use a hand towel today. So moderately sized towel, not a huge, maybe a dish towel, something about that big. And what we will wind up doing is just kind of rolling it, you know, like if you were in high school and you were going to snap somebody with a towel, that kind of roll. We'll use it for both some leg work and we'll also use it for some flexibility, mobility work. Okay? You need a chair, sturdy chair. If you want to get on the floor at the towards the end, we will do a little bit of floor work. And at that point, if you want to just say, I'm done, that's fine. Okay? About 40 minutes, maybe, I'd say. I see people are joining us. Hey, Radhika, I see you. Good to see you guys here. So let's go ahead and get started with a little bit of warm-up. I'm going to start the music. I'm trying to look at my volume. It looks like they're about okay. So I'm going to go ahead and start the music. And if the music's too loud, just drop me a quick text in the chat. Those of you who can chat, just send me a message and say, too loud, too loud. Okay? Let's get warmed up. Let's speak Carolina. All right. So take a deep breath up. And exhale down. And again, breathe up. And again, same thing. Let's roll those shoulders back. You know, right about the time I get this live stream stuff figured out will be the time that we open the building. Four more times. Four. Three. Two. Good. Roll the other way. Forward roll. Seven. Six. Four more times. Four. Three. Two more. Two. Good. All right, we're going to move side to side. Right, left, right? Right, left, right, left. There you go. Good. Push straight down. So I'm just bending my knees a little bit. Becca, just missing. Bend that right, bend that left. You're reaching toward the ground a little bit. Reach to me. Reach, reach, reach. Eight more times. Give me eight, six, four, three. Good. Hands up. Good. Good. Keep going. Reach out to me. Four. Good. Up, up, up. Sweet Caroline. Up, up, up. All right. Let me hear you all the way over here in 5 points. Push it up. Good. Reach up. Say it. So good. So good. So good. You know what to say there. I want you yelling it so your next door neighbor is thinking, what is going on in that house over there? Four. Three. Close the door, right and left. Oop. Right, left. I keep getting my sides mixed up, sorry. There you go. Bring it under. Nice, we're still just leaning side to side. Four, three, two, good. Right, both arms. Reach. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Good. Out to the side. Open. Open. There you go. Good. Good. Say it. Say it good. So good. So good. So good. Reach out. Reach out. I keep getting my walls here, y'all. All right. Reach one arm forward, one arm backward. Like you're skiing. Okay. Right foot. Tap your right toe. Tap, 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 tap. Tap, tap, tap. I'm going to turn my screen just a bit. Just a little bit lower. You know. A little bit lower. Hopefully you can see my feet. All right, tap, 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 tap. Now lift that toe and lift that toe and lift that toe and lift that toe. Up, up, up. Good. And again, keep going. Eight. Good. Four, three, two. Other side. We're going to tap this toe. A little tap, tap, tap. Tap, 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 tap. All right, we're going to lift that foot, lift that toe, lift, 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 there you go. Eight more, give me eight, six, four, three, good. Oh, they said it. All right, good job. I want you to take your hips in a circle. We're going to start to the right, push to the back, circle left, and around the other way, same thing, left. back, right? And I'm going slow on purpose. I'm doing that on purpose. I really want you to move through that full circle. See if you got any hitches in your giddy up anywhere. You know what I mean? Other way, same things. Great stretch if you've been sitting a lot. Who hasn't at this point? Okay, a little quicker. Circle around, other way. Circle around, other way. Circle, circle. Good. Good. All right. Arms up, we're going to rotate, rotate, rotate. So you're just turning at the rib cage right here. Good. So you see my knees are staying pretty straight, yes? You don't want to turn those knees in that way. Eight more times. That is eight. Six. Four. Three. Good. Deep breath up. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Same thing. Breathe up. And down. Beautiful, you guys. All right. Shake it out. Shake it out. You should feel like you're getting warm right now. We're going to go ahead and start with some body weight exercises. I do want you to get your towel, your hand towel. So one little hand towel. Okay? I'm going to hold it the long way and just roll it into a big tube, a big log, a big whatever you want to call that. Okay? I'm holding on to it at the ends. Yes? Okay. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is just work on a little bit of balance. You're going to lift the hands and pick up your right knee. So you're going to lift and bring it down. Everything touches. Lift. Bring everything down. So you're trying to keep those hips square, trying to resist the urge to let the hips swing sideways. So keep those hips square, shoulders square. Everything stacked, one on top of the other. All right? Now what I'm going to do is, as I reach back with that right leg, I'm going to start to go back a little farther every time. Ooh, there goes my balance. See that? Good. Now I'm getting constant feedback from my, trying to find the level. Good. Level belt line, as they say. Level belt line. Good. There's my balance on that leg. Good. One more time. Up and down. Good. All right. We're going to switch sides. Same thing. Just a knee lift. Left knee. Left and touch. You back up a bit. Lift and touch. Boy, look how much more stable I am on this side. Wow. Big difference. Up. Touch. I'm trying to find a place where I don't hit the wall, you guys. Lift. Touch back. Nice straight line in those arms. Good. I'm going to make it a little bigger. Up. Reach way back. Seven. Way back. Six. Way back. Five. Four more. Three more. Three. Two more. Two. Way back. One more. Up. Way back. Very nice. All right. Good job. Side knee. We're going to hold the band right there. And if you want to go full length above your head, go ahead and do that. You can't see my arms if I do that, so I'm going to keep my elbows a little bit bent, okay? Now what I'm going to do is bring my right knee up and tilt to the right side with my right elbow and then put it down. So it looks like that. Squeeze and relax. You should feel those oblique muscles in your side contracting. I want you to pull down with that right arm. Pull with that right arm. There goes my chandelier. Do you hear that? Pull. Pull. Squeeze those lats. You should be feeling that squeeze in your side. Ooh. Good. Four more. Four. Three. Two more. Two. Okay, bring it back to the center. Hold those arms straight. You're going to pick up your left knee and touch. And as your left knee comes up, your left elbow goes squeeze. 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 There you go. Ooh. Squeeze outside. But keep hitting the wall. Hang on, we move over. Beautiful, y'all. Eight more times. Eight. Seven.
Nice. Four. Three. Two more. Two. One more. Okay, nice job. Go ahead, bring it on down.
I'm just going to double check because my phone makes it look like this has stopped. Let me see. Are we still livin'? Oh, I think we stopped. Hang on, I think we live stream stopped. I'm going to stop this just for a second and restart it because I think it's stopped. All right. Did we poop out? Let's see. All right, are we going? Give me a shout if we are. We should be. Woo! Hot, 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 hot.
All right, there we go. All right, we are back online. Okay, good.
It might have stopped for a second, then we should be back on. Thanks.
Okay. Thanks, Lise. This technology thing is crazy. Okay?
All righty.
Another movement. We're coming across the body this time. So you're going to pick up your right heel and bring it across your body, and you're going to bring the towel down to the inside of your heel. So inside and the legs. Lots of balance today. You're probably noticing that, right? Lots of balance. Something we're not getting enough practice with right now. So good. So you're just trying to touch the inside of that calf with your towel. Four more. Four, three, two more, two, other side, same thing, here we go, there you go, beautiful, eight more times, eight, seven, six, four more times, four. So after this, I'm going to slow it down a little bit. We're going to pick up our weights, do some weight work. Okay? Actually, no, there's one more thing we're going to do. With the towel. Okay. Drive those hips back. Hands come forward. Squat down, lift the towel. Bring it back to the center. Squeeze those glutes. So it goes. Out. Sit. Middle. Squeeze. Out. Sit. Squeeze. I really want you to think about that hip hinge before you start bending your knees. Hip hinge, bend the knees. All right, same thing. Out. Ooh. There we go. Yeah, yeah. Eight more. Eight. Seven more. Six more. That's it. Four more. Three more. Ooh. Last two. One more. Nice job, you guys. All right. Good job. Relax. Ooh, that heated me. Okay. Weights. You need some weights. We're going to do squats with the weights. So I'm probably going to go a little heavier because I have heavier and lighter weights with me. You can choose what you want to do with this one, okay? I'm going to slow it down. Whew. Okay. So grab your weights. Good chance to grab some water if you need some water. I'm just kind of letting the stream catch up with me here. Alrighty. You guys don't realize this, but you're about... Gosh, you're way behind me. You're way behind me. Big delay between what I do and what you see. You're about 30 seconds behind me, I think. Okay. Okay, we're going to squat. Palms up. Sit. Bring it up. Sit. Bring it up. Just watching because you're right at the point where I stopped the stream and hopefully it comes back. All in business. Squat. Squeeze your butt. Squat. Squeeze your butt. Squat. Squeeze your butt. Okay, hold the weights here. Double down. Squat, squat, stand up. Squat, squat, stand up. So it's one, two, up. One, two, up. One, two, up. Think about chest proud, shoulders back, not hunching your shoulders this way. No. Elbows into your sides. One, two, up. One, two, up. Four, three, two. Good job. All right, hold it here. Bring those hands down. All right, you guys. I'm just double checking my live stream again because it looks like it's starting to green. Okay. All right. Okay. So if it's not running right now, I apologize. I think it's running. Yeah, here it is. Back. Okay. You guys may have had to restart it again. I have a feeling, the thing is, on Tuesdays at 10 o'clock, my daughter does online school, and my husband has a conference call. So we're all competing for the bits and bytes, and so I think that's what happens. Okay? But hopefully you guys got back in with me here. Okay, so we just did a set of squats, and what we're going to do is another set of squats. We're going to squat and add a rotation. So we're going to come down, back up, squat down. We're going to add a rotation as we lift the weights, bring them back to the center, and come back up. And again, we'll squat, curl, and add a little rotation. Now notice my knees are staying forward. See that? Back to the center, and up. So let me show you that at tempo. Down, rotation, and up. Down, rotation, and up. Good. Down. And again. Woo! There we go. Oh yeah! That's it. And again, sit, rotation. And again, sit, rotation. Two more. Good, one more. Sit, rotation. Beautiful, stand up tall. Flex your right foot. This is a straight leg kick. So kick and touch. Kick and touch. Kick and touch. Kick and touch. Up and touch. Up and touch. Ooh. Foreshortening on my foot. I'm not getting sound all of a sudden. Up. Here we go. Lift. And lift. Good. I see what the problem is. Keep going. Lift. And lift. Six. Five. Four more. Four. Three. Beautiful. Two. Other leg. Same thing. Nice. Stand tall. Make sure you're not hinging forward the hips, so you don't want your body to tilt forward and you don't want to lean backwards. Stand tall. Think about engaging that core muscle, those core muscles. So tightening up a belt of muscle around your middle. Four more. Four. Three, two more. Two. All right, right leg, we're gonna pick up the knee, curl the hand as we take the knee up and out. Bring it down, up and out. All right, looks like this. Up and out, up and out, up and out. Everything is saying, come on to me, come here. Ooh, there you go. That's it. Again. Six more. That's six. Four more. Four. Three. Two more. Two. Beautiful. Nice job, you guys. Okay. You need one weight. We're going to do triceps with a glute extension. Now I'm going to use the chair just for balance. And if you don't need to, you don't have to use the chair. But I'm going to show you this with a chair, and then you decide if you want to skip the chair. Okay? One hand on the chair for balance. And the only reason is because I don't want you shifting this way as you lift your leg. So as you lift your right leg, you don't want to have your hips shift in one direction. Okay? You want to try to keep those hips square. So as you lift, you're lifting straight back. Okay? So this is my lifting leg right here. All right, here we go. I'm going to kick it back. Kick. Whoop. There's a box down there I'm kicking. Kick. Kick. Squeeze. Good. Trying to keep those hips square. So what you don't want to have happen is that. See how my hip is rotating out? Don't let that hip rotate. Square. Eyes are on the horizon. Looking straight forward. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Good. Elbow high. Extend the triceps. Hooray! Little tiny pulses, everything. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Yes? Here we go. Oh. 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 All right, good job. Turn that chair around. Starting just with the leg. You switched hands with the weight. Hips square. Squeeze those glutes. Keep going. Squeeze. Squeeze. Nice. Good. Don't lock the standing knee. Keep that standing knee nice and soft. Nice and soft. Good. Four more. Four. Three. Beautiful. Okay. Right elbow, left, or your elbow, whatever elbow you're doing. Yeah, it looks like you're right. No, it looks like you're left. Whew. Good, there you go, you guys. All right, little pulses, here we go. Everything pulses. Oh, hey! Good, eight more, last eight. Give me eight. Six. Good job. Okay. You need your chair. Okay. Holding the weight in front of you. Now this is, again, work for your hip. Ready? Back up a little bit. What we're going to try to do is sit and then try to come up using mostly one leg. The weight helps to counteract your body weight to help get you out of the chair. All right? So I'm going to sit down. What I want you to do is see if you can extend one leg out in front of you a little bit. You take that down just a bit. So you can see what I'm doing here. And I might turn it sideways too. Alright, these are modified pistol squats. Alright, one leg out. Now, if your knee's real bad and this hurts, you might need to bring 2 feet. Okay, and then take your foot out as you stand up. But if you can, one leg all the way out, push that weight out and pull up with it. Right? Now, 2 feet together to sit, or if you can, keep that leg out in front, all right? Push up all that leg, and then see if you can sit with it. Yes? Here we go. Up. Down. That's a pistol squat. Now, if you find you're losing your balance or you're uncomfortable without your hands, please use your hands. I don't want you falling off your chair. And again. Ooh, I gotta make sure my aim is good. Ooh, almost missed it. One more time. All right, nice job. We're gonna turn around. I'm gonna go the onion. You're gonna switch legs. I'm gonna turn around. See how we do. That was my bad knee, so we'll see how we do with my other knee. Okay. Once again, leg extended. Push the weight out and follow it. Go ahead, take it down. Ooh, I'm looking at myself in the mirror, so I can keep an eye on my chair. If you need to look down at your chair, make sure you land, stick your landing. Go ahead and do that. Good. Four. Three. Two more. One more. All right, beautiful. Nice job. Okay, you guys. Woo. Okay. Go ahead and put your weight down. We're going to use your towel for this part, okay? It's going to provide a little bit of resistance as you push the leg in. So what I'm doing is going around one thigh, one leg. And I'm going to hold it out to the side as best I can. And what I'm trying to do is push in against that towel. Push in against that towel. And push and relax. So we're trying to work the inner thigh on that right leg. Press and relax. You're resisting with your hands. You're going to feel your obliques working quite a bit on this one. Good. Nice. Two more sets of eight. One. Two. Well, I'm looking at myself in the video doing those pistol squats. Boy, that was a sloppy squat I was doing. Hopefully your form was better than mine. Eight more times. Sit up tall, you guys. Sit up tall. Don't slouch. Make space between your ribs and your hips. Make space. Ooh, my hips getting tired. My inner thighs getting tired. Two more. One more. All right, good job. Other side. So once again, you're going to make resistance by using that towel to pull your leg out as you push it in. Here we go. Good. Just because I'm push, relax, push, relax, push, relax. Good. Keep going. Good, keep going. Nice, keep going. Resist. Hold that leg back. Oh. Eight more. She's my uptown girl. This would be a good synchro song, please. Good, beautiful, you guys. I just think it. Just think it. Okay. All right. Ooh, I am sweating. Okay. Put your towel down. We are going to do some chest work. And what we're going to do is use your weights, light or heavy. And what I'm going to have you do is just slouch in your chair. So I'm going to turn sideways and show you what I'm going to do. And we're going to do one arm at a time because you're going to use your other hand to support your head. Okay? So this is going to be something we would call an incline chest press. So I'm scooting way out to the end of my chair. See that? Lots of space behind me. I'm going to lean back. I'm going to use my head to support my neck. So I'm trying to get my body in a nice straight line. Other hand is at the shoulder. Push it straight up the neck. Push. So this is an incline bench press. Pushing uphill. Eight. Seven. Six. Four more. Two more. Keep going. I'm going to turn so I can see what we're doing here. Okay, good job. Relax. You're going to change your arms. So the hand is behind the other head. Ready? Here we go. Two sets of eight. Push. Push. Always an active core. Always pulling in at your core. Always pulling, pulling, pulling. Squeezing your abdominals. Four, three, two, and one. Good job. All right, now take that weight in both hands. Take the weight up. Tuck your chin into your neck. So you're making a double chin in your neck just to support your neck a little bit here. So double tuck that chin in. take the weights to the left, take the weights to the right. Just a little bit of a windshield wiper motion here. Just a little bit. You should feel your spine stiffen. You should feel your obliques pull real hard to stop that weight from going. 8, 7, 6, four more, 4, and 3, two more, one more. Ooh, good job, sit up nice and tall. Come on. Okay, we're gonna try a single arm fly, single arm fly. So we're gonna go back to that original body position we were just in. So, right hand, let's do it with left hand first. So right hand behind the head, slouch way back. Bend the elbow, see what looks like a parenthesis there? And we're gonna open it out to the side just a little bit, and then bring it up in. So your elbow stays in that curved position. Just go as far as you can without your shoulder hurting. Really engage those abs, pull those belly button muscles in tight. Four more. Ooh, three more. 3, 2 more. Last one. Okay, relax. Sit up nice and tall. Relax your head, relax your neck. We're gonna go to the other side. So left hand behind the head. Find that slouch. Not really a slouch, but a plank. We're gonna call it a seated plank. How's that? Hand off. Elbow slightly bent, parenthesis. Here we go. Out, keep that slight bend in your elbow. You should feel a tug at your shoulder and at your chest. I'm exhaling as I lower. Good, 8 more times. 8, 7 more, 7, 6 more. Beautiful. Last 4, 4, 3 more, 3, last 2. 1 more. Okay, good job. Bring it on up. Oh, man. Let's go ahead and stay seated. I'm going to take your right elbow, drop it just inside your right thigh. Left hand is on your legs. Your knees are wide. Your feet are flat, okay? Down and up. That's your biceps concentration curl. Good. Keep going. Be back up. Show you where I am here. So you want your arm to come all the way straight. All the way straight. Sitting up, lifting the chest. Chest is proud. Shoulders back. That's it. Good. 8 more. 8, 7, 6. 4 more. 2 more. 1 more. Excellent job. All right, bring that hand up. We're going to switch sides. Same thing. Elbow is inside your thigh. Try not to roll your wrist. Like, see, I had my wrist rolled. Flatten out that wrist. Straight arm, curl to the chest. Straight arm, curl to the chest. Beautiful. Keep going. Good. 1 more set of 8. 8, 7, 6. 4 more, please. 4, 3, 2. Excellent job. Okay, we're going to go ahead and stand up. Put your hand on the seat of the chair if you can reach it. Now, if that bothers your back, or if you find that this makes you go really, really low, then I want you to go ahead and bring your hand to the back of the chair. Ideally, you've got your back to be almost like flat like a table, okay? Or maybe a little bit higher than a table. You don't want to have your head below your hips, okay? So find that flat table or somewhere right about there, all right? Now this arm right here that's got the weight in it, what I'm going to do is try not to, see now my shoulder's dropped and my shoulder blade muscles, my rhomboids and all those scapular muscles are all being real lazy right now. I'm going to try to tighten everything up and bring that shoulder back into alignment. So instead of being there, I'm here before I ever start doing anything. So I'm squeezing my scapular muscles, trying to turn that scapula down into a letter J. Bringing that scapula down and in into a letter J, okay? Scap J, it's been called Scap J, okay? That's a TRX thing, Scap J. Okay, right here, find your flat back, engage those back muscles, those scapular muscles, and then row. Now, as you lower the arm, don't let the shoulder drop. Keep that shoulder up, engage that scapular set of muscles, keep your posture good in your shoulders and in your upper back. There you go. You'll feel it working a lot harder. There you go. Keep that belly button pulled in tight. Tuck your tailbone a little bit. Don't let your back arch, right? Pull that belly button in. Tuck that tailbone. There you go. Engage and squeeze. Engage and squeeze. Okay, we're going to add the triceps back in here. So pull, extend the arm back, woo, bring it in, don't let the shoulder drop. Up, back, in, and again, keep that scapular complex of muscles tight and pulling in those shoulder blades down towards your back pockets. Two more. One more. Okay, beautiful. We're going to go ahead and turn around. Just let your back relax, your low back relax for a second or two there. All right? Okay, same thing. We're going to think about scapular muscles right here pulling down and in. So you want that scapula to come across toward the opposite hip. Scap J makes the letter J. Okay? One hand on the chair. Find that flat back. Engage your scapular muscles so your shoulder is not drooping, and then pull, row. Row and relax. Don't let that shoulder drop. There you go. Once again, tuck your tailbone a little bit. If you're feeling it in your low back, tuck your tailbone. Turn my hand around. You see what I did? Turn my hand around the other way. That was more comfortable than this one. Eight more, and then we're going to add the triceps. I keep arching my back on this side for some reason. Tucking my tailbone. Think about tucking my tailbone. Okay, we're going to add the triceps in. Pull, extend the arm. Good. Do it again. Seven more. Good. Five more. Row. Extension. Good. Four more. Once again, don't let that shoulder drop. I just felt mine drop on that last one. Two more. One more. Ooh, good job. All right. Go ahead and put those weights down. It is, let's see, it's about 10. Okay. So we're going to do a little bit of calf raise on one foot, on one foot. So this is just working on the strength of one calf and your balance a little bit. Now I do have a chair just because I don't want you jumping around a lot. I'm going to put my hands just above the chair, not actually touching, but it's there if I start to lose my balance, okay? I'm going to stand on one leg, I don't care which one, and I'm going to take my other foot and either hold it in front of me or wrap it around that ankle. I do better with a wrap. I do better with an ankle wrap. And if you find that's better for your balance, go ahead and do it. Or if you're better with your foot in front, do it that way. Okay? So what I'm going to do is wrap this ankle, and I'm trying to push up and down. Once again, if you need to put a couple fingers on that chair for your balance, that's fine. You should feel this in your Achilles tendon, your low calf, your ball of your foot, your arch of your foot. This is lower leg strength right here, y'all. Lower leg strength. And balance. Cheating, I keep putting my hand on the wall behind me. 8 more. Pull that belly button in tight. Use that column of strength to maintain your balance. 4 more. 4. 3. 2 more. 1 more. All right, good job. Now we're going to go ahead and do the other leg. Same thing. So you're standing on the other foot. Once again, you can either do the ankle wrap or you can pick your foot up in front. Standing tall. You go ahead and lift and lower. I can't do it all with my foot in front. Just can't do it. Something about that throws my balance way, way off. Oops. Up and down. Good. Up. Up. Nice. 8 more. Give me 4 more. 2 more. Nice. Good job, you guys. Okay. Ooh. Relax. We are done with all the strength stuff, except we're going to do a little bit of floor work for anybody that wants to stay and do a little bit of work for your butt. And we'll probably do a little more core. Even though we've done a lot of core seated in the chair, we did a ton. But we might do a little bit more using your towel. Okay? Everybody else, if you don't want to stay for that, we're just going to do a quick stretch or two. Hands on the back of your chair. Walk your feet back. Drive your hips way, way back behind you. Bring your ears between your arms. I'm going to turn that music down just as much. All right, we're right here. Now we're going to do that cat to cow stretch. So pull the belly button up and round the middle of your back, your T-spine, your thoracic spine. Now lower that belly button, lift your tailbone, and lift your chin just a little bit, looking forward. Now once again, drop your chin, drop your tailbone, pull up to the center of your body. All right, drop that belly button, lift your chin, lift your tailbone. Okay, good job, you guys. Come on up from there. We're going to do a hip stretch because we did a lot of hip work. So I'm going to stand arm's length away from the chair. Full arm's length. See, I'm even leaning a little bit. I'm going to take my outside leg. Whatever that for on there, it looks like my right leg. You're going to pick up your outside leg, step over, hold on to that chair, step over the inside leg, big, 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 big. And then see how I've rolled that foot that I stepped over? So now you should be getting a stretch in the hip and the IT band. And you're leaning on that chair and getting that hip stretch. Now the trick is getting out of this, especially you, Dolly. So you're really going to hang on. And you can kind of check in with your body and feel, is it going to be better for me to pull that foot in or to move that one out? So kind of feel where you are. And for some people, it feels better to turn this way first. Okay? For me, it's better to pick my back foot up. So what I'm going to do is push on that chair and slide that back foot in. Okay? Now we're going to do the other side. So I'm going to turn my chair around here. Arms length away from the chair. I'm even leaning into it a little bit. We're going to take the outside leg, step over the inside leg. I'm holding onto that chair and I'm leaning into the outside part of that back leg, the back foot. And I'm getting a stretch on the hip and down the side of the leg a little bit. It's not a huge stretch, just enough that you know your hip is there. Okay, and once again, just kind of checking with your body and feel, where do I want to go from this? Do I want to pull the back foot in? Do I want to try to move that front foot? Figure out what's going to work, all right? I'm going to slide my back foot in because that's what works for me. Okay? All right. Now, we are going to go ahead and I'm actually going to go to the side of the chair. So I'm going to do a side stretch. Now, if you have back fusion, things like that, you're going to stay up here on this part of the chair. All right? But if you can do a bigger stretch, you're going to come down to the seat of the chair. And what we're trying to do is get a stretch to the side of your body. So if you can move your spine side to side, go for it. If you have really bad osteoporosis, you're not going to be down there. If you've had spinal fusion, you're not going to be down there. You're going to be up here. Okay? Oh, that feels good, doesn't it, though? Whatever you're doing, it feels good. Now, come on up. We're going to go ahead. I'm just going to turn around. We're going to do the other side. Same thing, either the back of the chair or the seat of the chair. Up and over. All right, relax that stretch. Go ahead and have a seat real quick. A couple hamstring stretches. Okay. Extend one leg out, and we're leaning out over the leg. Or if you have the ability to grab that toe, you can also stretch the hamstring this way, and then you're really, really going to get your calf. All right? Ha-ha! So either leaning out over the leg, or pick that foot up and stretch it this way. Flex that foot. Good. We're just about done. It is, yeah. I'm about a minute or so ahead of you guys on the live stream, so we have about 5 minutes. All right, put that foot down. This is the last stretch we're doing. After this, we're going to go ahead and get on the floor. So if you want to get on the floor and do a couple more things with me, that'd be great. Otherwise, thanks for joining me. All right, so once again, you're here, or if you want to, you can bring it up here. All right, relax. Now what I'm going to do is make some room here to get on the floor. I'm going to tilt the screen down just a bit so you guys can see me. All righty. Get my chair out of the way. All right, the only thing you need for this is your towel. Okay? That's it. It's all you need. We're just going to do a little bit of glute work, a little bit of butt work, just because that's one of the first muscles to go when you sit a lot, is the glutes get very, very weak. So we're going to work on pressing with those glutes, also because we don't climb stairs as much. That's the other reason. Okay? We're going to do a little bit of glute work, and then we're going to do some one ab exercise with a towel, and then, actually we're doing that first. Okay? And then we're going to stretch. A little bit more stretching. Okay. So, we're going to do a Russian twist with the towel. Ooh. Alrighty? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cross my ankles. Gosh, I haven't done a Russian twist in a while. Oh, I don't know about this. Alright? I'm going to bring my arms up. And what I'm trying to do is pull in through the abdominals. So pull your belly button in, lean back, and bring the towel toward one side. Back up to the center. Bring it down to the other side. And back up to the center. It should almost look, and in fact, you could do that, it looks like a kayak row. Yeah? Alright? So here's how I'm doing it, kayak row. Pull and up. Pull and up. Lean. Lean. I'm actually cheating a little bit because I got my feet against the wall. See that? It's harder if you don't have anything to brace on. It's way harder. So if you're struggling, put your toes on the baseboard. It's like magic. You're engaging with your hip flexors with your feet. So you're using your abs to move through your body. Ooh. All right, y'all, I'm gonna go to like the dollar store and buy 25 hand towels. That's gonna be the new prop in the cardinal room when we're back in there, I just decided, because this is awesome. Two more, or maybe we'll all just bring our own. All right, relax, good job. Oh, enough of that, okay. You're going to go ahead and lay flat. I'll go this way. Lay flat. Now we're going to do a single leg press, glute press. Now unless there is just no way, if you cannot get up with one leg, you'll have both feet on the floor. We're going to do two sets. So either you're going to do two sets of a hip bridge with both feet on the floor, or you'll do one set with one leg up, one set with the other leg up. Okay? Alrighty. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this leg. You have several options. On the heel, on the knee rather. Or you can take it straight up, which is a little bit harder. Or the hardest way to do this is to have the leg straight out in front of you. Okay? Engage those abdominals. Find your version. I'm going to go right in the middle here. Okay? I'm going to push and lift those hips. Up and relax. Hands are either side of your hip. And you're squeezing your butt. Squeeze tight. Press and relax. Press and relax. We got it. And again, keep going. Ooh, beautiful. Two more. One more. All right, relax. Put that foot down if you've got one foot in the air. Other leg, other heel, straight up to the front. Or another set with both feet on the floor. Your choice. Here we go. Up, up. Lift and relax. Apparently it's dusty down here. Oh, I know what it is. My cat was just here scratching. It's cat fur. I have the cats double locked out of this room so they wouldn't bother us this week. Good. 7, 6, and 5, 4 more, 4, 3, last 2, 2, last 1, oh, that felt good. Okay, hug those knees into your chest, hug them in tight, just squeeze those knees in. Alrighty, relax as much as you can, so you're just hugging those knees to your chest. Hang on just a second here. Whew. All right, relaxed. Now what I want you to do is just rock those knees side to side, just a little bit. Just a little bit of movement, side to side. Ugh. Just put some quiet music on here, if I can find some. I keep using the same one over and over. I'm going to use something else here. Angels' Voices, what do you think that is? Let's find out. All right, now. Yeah, that's good. This kind of music. One leg up. I'm going to bring that leg across your body. Now I see my other knee's bent. See that? I'm trying to keep my hips close to the floor. So in other words, I'm not rolling up on my side. I'll do that in a second. Now I've got my arms out to the side. I've got my shoulders flat. If that's bothering your knee joint, just support the knee. Sometimes that inward pressure at the knee joint can bother if you have, especially if you have meniscus tears in there, you can put too much pressure in there and hurt. Okay? Now I'm going to roll onto the side of this bent knee. So I'm going to roll all the way over and let that leg come down. Still trying to keep the shoulders flat. Go ahead and bring that knee back up. So bend that knee, bring it back up. Now this leg that was on the top, the one that was just stretching, you're going to bend that knee. Straighten the other leg. Bring it across your body, right? Let the hips stay on the floor. I have to tell you guys, I was Zooming with my family the other day. This is why the cats are locked out. I was Zooming with my family the other day. I'm just going to talk at you. I'll tell you what to do in a second. And one of the cats comes in and plops down in front, like on my lap, and starts going, and then did a hairball, like right in my lap, in front of my entire family. So that's why the cats are banished. They've got that spring thing where they're eating so much hair that they're barfing up hairballs. Okay, over. Roll yourself over onto that other leg. Oh, that feels good. Trying to keep the shoulders flat. Okay. Okay, bend that top knee and bring those legs back in. And come on up to a seated position. Feet together, knees apart. Open up those knees. Sit up nice and tall. We're just about done. I know it is almost 11. I need to drop your chin and roll your belly button in. Pull your belly button in. Okay, relax. Now bring those knees together. Wrap your arms around your legs and hug your knees. Bring your chest forward to your knees. All right, sit up nice and tall. Take a deep breath up. Exhale down. Give yourselves a hand. Thank you so much, you guys. Still working on the technology here, but I think we got through the whole class, it looks like. So thanks for joining me. In case you didn't see the news item yet, we don't have Zoom class on Thursday because my daughter's high school is doing a drive-through senior parade. So I will be driving through the parking lot at Broughton High School. Probably, I think, maybe we're renting a fire truck. Anyway, long story. I'll send you pictures. So I will talk to y'all later.